A new Rec Room Plus item, a new contest announced, and an Xbox promotional item teased. I'm Billabob from BVR, and this is Rec Room Weekly. First, let's talk about this new update. Even though there wasn't technically like a new update name for it, they just kind of rolled out these features unofficially, I guess. So instead of an update changelog, we have a blog post to go with it, I guess. So let's go through this. The first big change is for Rec Room Plus members. Now, all members of Rec Room Plus will have access to keys and premium inventions. This has been in beta for quite a while to a closed group of people, but it's actually just been released for all Rec Room Plus members. So basically, this gives access to all Rec Room Plus members to make keys in their rooms, which basically means like players can buy costumes with actual Rec Room tokens and it goes to the room creators. And then they also have access to premium inventions, which basically means if you upload an invention to the invention store, you can set a price and tokens for it. This has been expected for quite a while now. I mean, it's been in beta for multiple months, but it's nice to finally see it actually roll out to all Rec Room Plus members, and now all Rec Room Plus members have some extra ways to make some tokens. The second big update is that pretty much the entire way that you get rewards after games and from daily and weekly challenges has been changed. Now, usually when playing Rec Room games, sometimes you'll get boxes just for tokens randomly. Also, on your first game of the day, you'll usually get like a first game of the day box. And these will usually have anywhere from like 10, 20, 100, even 500 tokens sometimes. But it was very RNG based and you'd usually just get like 10 or 20. So now basically, in place of getting random token boxes on these events like first game of the day and whenever you complete a game sometimes, a little menu will pop up and give you three selections between three different items you can pick from. Now, these three selections can be basically anything, from clothing items, to tokens, to film, to root beer, to pizza, or whatever. And the team is claiming that basically now that there's these more expensive clothing items that you can get after games, that there is 10 times the value from the after game rewards. However, I'd say this is a little bit misleading. Well, yes, sometimes you can have the option of getting clothing items that are like 400, 500, 600 tokens. Usually, at least two out of your three options are gonna be like absolute garbage, like either root beer or film or something you're never gonna use. And on the occasions that you do get these outfits that are worth multiple hundreds of tokens, half the time they're just gonna be outfits that you don't even want anyways. Also, now that all this other stuff can happen after you play a game, getting actual tokens is very, very hard. A good majority of your time, none of your selections are gonna involve tokens at all. And when they do, it might just be like 20, 30 tokens. So yes, you might technically be getting 10 times the value in tokens if you pick the highest rated item every single time, but this basically makes it way harder to actually just grind games for tokens now to be able to buy what you actually want, because you really don't get tokens super often anymore. So I still don't know how to feel about this change. I kind of like the concept behind it, but I think it could use some working out. Maybe have it so that at least one of the slots is always tokens. Also, no one wants film. I get maybe like food items showing up sometimes, like cake or donuts or pizza or something. And I get that for a selection like this, there has to be some like lower level items. So I'm fine with food being in there and stuff, but just remove the like sepia and black and white film from the selection. Action, please. Nobody is ever going to pick the film, and having that there just takes away from another valuable option that they could have had. Oh yeah, and as I said earlier, there's also been changes to daily challenges. Now, instead of getting like 10 tokens every time you do one of the daily challenges, and then I think like 20 when you complete them all, you no longer get anything for doing individual challenges. You only get a reward once you complete all three of them. And for doing that, now instead of just getting 20 tokens, you get one of these pop-ups that lets you select, like I've just previously explained. I'm pretty sure this is like the exact same sort of selection menu, so all the same problems I just went over still apply. And finally, the most unanimously good change that they made in this update is that now whenever you get a weekly that you already had, instead of just getting the skin again, so you basically get nothing, you now get a 4-star box if you already had that weekly skin. I have no idea how it took them this long to implement this. Like, if there was a repeat weekly, there was basically no incentive for people to go and do it. So this is a really nice and welcome change. So that's pretty much everything that was changed in this update. Again, it wasn't technically like an update. I don't even know. A lot of ups and downs. I think if tweaked a little bit, this new system could be really good, but as it stands, I just don't think you get enough tokens and you just get more garbage than anything. All right, let's take a look at this week's weekly rotation of items. The weekly skin for this week is Christmas themed. However, it is a repeat. It's the Peppermint Laser Pistol skin. And here are some of the challenges that you can do to get this skin. There is a new Rec Room Plus item. It is a reskin of the Bear Hug hat. It is a Holiday Panda Bear Hug hat. And also, this one is limited time. I'm assuming after December, it'll be going away. Here's a comparison comparison of this new panda holiday bear hug hat, and then here I switch back to the normal bear hug hat. You can see the similarities, but honestly, it feels like a completely new item, basically. Also, there's two new items in the Rec Center shop this week. They're the gray and black fancy capes, and honestly, these are way better than the, like, royal capes or whatever. I'm not a fan of the royal capes. They don't really seem like capes either, so I don't know if that's the best word, but yeah, they look pretty cool. The weekly invention tower theme for this week is sci-fi, so if you want some premium inventions under that theme, make sure to go to the invention tower room and check out some of the premium inventions. In other news, a brand new Rec Room build contest was announced. Now, they are really pumping these things out. Like, the mystery contest just ended, like, a week or two ago. I remember the gap between contests being a lot longer than this, but I really think they're just trying to make it so that there's always some build contest happening. The theme for this contest is movie magic. If you don't know how the build contests work, basically there is a set time limit that people have to create a room under a certain theme. And then there's also 5 subcategories they can go for. Their game, art, hangout, PvP, and quest. And then the winners get a special outfit and a Maker Pen skin. Now the outfit for this one's just a recolor of the Bog Monster outfit, and it doesn't even have the cuffs. I mean, I get they're going for like black and white because like old movies or something, but clearly this is not the like highlight prize, because this Maker Pen skin might be the best one they've made so far. It's just so like 3D, and it's so big. The Mystery Maker Pen was pretty dang cool, but they might have topped that here. I am really liking these new Maker Pen skins they've been doing for the contest. Also for this contest, they changed the rewards so that now not just the first place gets the Maker Pen skin, but the top 3 of every category does. And then they also extended the rewards of the costume to the like top 10 as well. I'm not totally certain yet, but I know I'm going to be participating in this contest in some capacity, whether that's just making a trailer or whether it's making an actual room. We'll see, but I'm definitely going for something, and good luck to anybody participating. In other news, a brand new Xbox promotional item has been spotted recently. On RecNet, a lot of the community team members and developers have been posting pictures of them wearing a helmet that looks a lot like Master Chief's. We don't know too much about this besides that everyone will be able to get it, and it won't just be exclusive to people who come on Xbox. Because in case you were wondering, Rec Room is going to be coming to Xbox at some point next year, I'm pretty sure. And that's probably why they're doing this Xbox promotion, and they've just been teasing it a little bit recently. Anyways, this helmet looks super cool. I'm sure all the Halo fans will be like hyped or whatever. I don't know. I've never played Halo. And that's going to be about it for this week of Rec Room News. I hope you enjoyed. Make sure to subscribe if you did, and I'll see you next time. Goodbye. Hey, thanks for making it to the end of the video. You know, if you enjoyed it, there's a subscribe button right there, but, you know, no pressure. Also, I think there's a video you'll enjoy right here, so click on that if you'd like to, and that's about it. See you next time.